But first, the businessman Ben Dunn returned to the witness box on the second day of the Payments to Politicians Tribunal at Dublin Castle. Mr. Dunn told the inquiry that he never received any favour or benefit from Charles Haughey or any government of which he was a member or from any other politician or political party to which he made a contribution. Mr. Dunn earlier told the tribunal that he personally handed over three bank drafts worth more than £200,000 to Mr. Haughey in 1991. Counsel for the tribunal said that Mr. Haughey had been written to twice to say he was entitled to legal representation at the tribunal, but he had not sought such representation.
Ben Dunn told the tribunal today about three payments which were made after accountant Noel Fox passed on a message from Des Traynor that Charles Haughey was in financial difficulties. These payments were for £500,000 in July 1988, for £150,000 in May 1989, and for £200,000 in 1990. They were channeled through offshore bank accounts controlled by Mr. Dunn into the account in Dublin of a Cayman Islands bank. Mr. Dunn said he had no doubt that this money was destined for Mr. Haughey. Mr. Dunn then outlined an incident he alleged happened in 1991 when he called into Mr. Haughey's home in Kinsealy. Mr. Dunn said that Mr. Haughey appeared down and that he felt sorry for him. He said that he had in his possession three bank drafts for £70,000 each made out in fictitious names, which he had for another purpose. He said that as he was leaving, he handed these drafts to Mr. Haughey, saying, "That's something for yourself." He said Mr. Haughey replied, "Thank you, big fella." The three drafts were later deposited by the late Des Traynor in a bank account in Dublin, belonging to the Cayman Islands Bank used in the previous transactions. Asked by Michael Collins, counsel for the tribunal, whether he had ever received any favour, licence, grant or benefit from Mr. Haughey or a government of which he was a member, Mr. Dunn said, "No sir, no sir." Mr. Dunn said he was happy to make the payments because he didn't want to see a Taoiseach in financial difficulties. Dennis McCullough, counsel for the tribunal, said that Mr. Haughey had been written to twice to let him know he was entitled to legal representation at the tribunal. Mr. Haughey has not sought such representation. Under cross-examination by counsel for Fine Gael, Mr. Dunn said that he didn't seek or receive any favours in return for contributions to that party. He agreed that one of the payments to Fine Gael, a cheque for £50,000, was handed to John Bruton after Mr. Bruton called to see him at his home. Mr. Dunn was also asked about his business relationship with Michael Lowry. He said payments to Mr. Lowry were made as bonuses and incentives because his company, Streamline Enterprises, was saving Dunn Stores a lot of money. He added that the arrangement whereby Dunn Stores paid for renovations to Mr. Lowry's house was not unusual within the company and that work on other houses, including his own, had been paid for in this way. Mr. Dunn said he had never sought or received any political favours as a result of his relationship with Mr. Lowry. Accountant Noel Fox then gave evidence about the approaches made to him by Des Traynor. Mr. Fox said he had no doubt but that the money was going to Charles Haughey and he would not have passed the request on to Mr. Dunn if he doubted this.
Well, joining us from Dublin Castle is our special correspondent, Charlie Bird. Charlie, what was said at the start of the tribunal this morning?
Well, at the start of the tribunal this morning, Una, counsel for Mr. Lowry drew attention to what he said were inaccurate and unfair reports in the Irish Times newspaper this morning. He drew attention to a headline in the newspaper which said that Mr. Lowry had got a further £500,000 from Ben Dunn. Counsel said this was wrong and he drew attention to it. Counsel for the tribunal and also Mr. Justice McCracken said they also agreed it was wrong and asked the media to be more careful in their reporting. This report was also mentioned on what it said in the newspapers and RTE.
Mr. Dunn gave details of personally handing cheques to the Taoiseach, the then Taoiseach. How did that happen?
Well, yes, clearly this was one of the key moments of the evidence this morning. Mr. Dunn recalled going to Balltray Golf Club sometime in 1991. He was playing golf there. He couldn't exactly remember the date, but he said that he had these three bank drafts in his pocket. He also recalled in an amusing way that he had them in his pocket and that when he was teeing off and writing his scorecard, he was worried if they might fall out of his pocket. But he said that afterwards he rang Mr. Haughey and suggested that he would go around for a cup of tea. He said the two men, they talked for a while. It was small talk. He remembered referring to his own son's problem about a kidney complaint which he had. And that as he was leaving the house, he gave Mr. Haughey the three bank drafts. And he said, "There's something for yourself." To which Mr. Haughey replied, "Thank you, big fella."
Was there any... Sorry, yes. Charlie, was there any further reference by Mr. Dunn to Mr. Haughey today?
Well, sorry, counsel for the tribunal then asked Mr. Dunn if Mr. Haughey had asked for the money, and he said no, Mr. Haughey had not asked for the money. He said, I felt sorry for him. He looked like a broken man. Yes, there was other references to Mr. Haughey during the day, but all at the end of the hearing, just before lunchtime, counsel for the tribunal put a direct question to Mr. Dunn. It was very pointed and very clear. He said, I want to put it to you, did you receive any favours, licence, grants or benefit derived from Mr. Haughey or any government to which he was a member? To which Mr. Dunn replied, no sir, no. So clearly he was making it quite clear, which he's made throughout all his evidence, that he never received any benefit from Mr. Haughey.
Charlie, in Dublin Castle, thank you very much for talking to us.